Welcome back. A few years ago, a couple met on a dating app. Just a few days after their first date, they told each other, I love you.
But the details of their story and what they're fighting through together is something truly extraordinary.
News 4's Forrest Sanders reports.
We don't really celebrate Valentine's Day because we love each other every day. Pain in my butt.
What?
Nothing.
On a Valentine's with Sean Woodard and Amanda DiMarzio, you'll find some hearts, some cards, but it will be nowhere near the number of indestructible patriotic super soldier shields. Something about Captain America speaks to Sean.
You're the guy that always runs towards trouble and not away from it. It's Captain America-y.
But as much as he wants to, Sean can't shield Amanda from one thing. The reason. They can't sit side by side on this Valentine's.
She can't be closer than 6 feet to people for 3 days after treatment.
DiMarzio?
Yep.
I had cancer actually before I met Sean. That was one of the things before we even went on our first date, I told him about it.
And I'm gonna make sure your pick line works.
Sean and friend Devin go with Amanda to Vanderbilt for monthly treatments of her tumors.
Please maintain the six foot distance, ma'am. Ma'am, please.
She's been given a 10% chance of living longer than 5 years.
With the radiation, they take a lot of precautions. So actually, like, that's why everything is wrapped in plastic.
Ooh, can you read it?
So if I wear my socks, I don't get them back. They're gone forever. And these are not socks that you give up.
Do you want me to be honest, or do you want me to tell you what I've been telling everybody else?
No, it's fine. It's no big deal. Same as every other treatment.
No, I'm nervous. My body's probably going to be like, nope, sucks to be you.
But through all she's facing, Amanda has a constant. Someone who gets her through these days. Someone always there. Someone who asked her to be his wife.
So what's next?
Oh, we're gonna get married. I tell him to run all the time. Like, asking somebody to be with somebody who's sick, that's asking a lot.
I'm not a fan of running, I'm lazy. Because I love her and I don't wanna go anywhere. It's sickness or not, I'm here. Just to be with you, I'll do.
Hi.
How are you? I'm good, how are you?
As your wife, I promise to always buy Jif peanut butter and not the store brand. I will always watch paranormal videos every night with you at bedtime. You have taught me that truly loving someone really is unconditional. So when I say I love you to you, I say it with my entire soul.
And while Amanda has her hero.
Sean, you can kiss your bride.
Sean does too. It's someone who can take on the dark days with such bravery, with a smile.
And everything was just really nice to now it's like, kablah!
I was done. I knew that was it.
It's because I'm cute.
That helped.
Yeah. Now, how does that make you feel?
Who?
You.
Oh.
Undeserving, but kind of spoiled at the same time.
Do you want to draw first?
Yeah.
Back to this Valentine's.
But before I kill you, Mr. Bond, I must show you a monkey smoking a cigar.
Amanda and Sean wouldn't spend this day any other way.
In a bioengineered assault turtles.
Than with the people most important in their world.
Yeah, let's go with the turtles. Yeah. I have a white card.
Their story.
Thank you.
Is a lesson. Shield the one you love from what you can. Be there for what you can't.
I love you. You know how much?
How much?
With photojournalist Jordan Powell, I'm Forrest Sanders, News 4.
Remarkable story.
It's beautiful. And I think her personality may be the best medicine in this whole thing.
Talking about a story that puts everything in perspective. Now, the Wish Upon a Wedding organization paid for Sean and Amanda's wedding.
The organization grants weddings and vow renewals to couples facing serious illness.